So here with Patrick Timms, Deputy Editor of the Wolves of Westminster Blog. And we're in recess at the moment, Patrick, but that doesn't mean to say there's not stuff going on in Parliament. And it was recalled this week and due to the Afghanistan crisis. And we're in real trouble there, aren't we? And it's a bit of a foreign policy and diplomatic disaster, not for the US, mostly for the US, but also for the UK. And that was reflected in the debate in Parliament, wasn't it? Particularly from the Conservative backbenchers, very critical.
Yes, and I mean for the entire West, this just looks like a defeat for lots of people. I mean, it's one of those things. You know, a lot of voices are saying, look, that the typical question: if not now, then when? You know, when were we going to go? But I think that kind of misses the point to some degree. That if you're going to go, you've also got to go properly. And yes, as you say, there's been a lot of criticism in Parliament, so quite rightly, yes, on the backbenches of how this has been done. Then again, it's all very well to point the finger at the Prime Minister and at the Foreign Secretary, but really, this withdrawal was prompted by the decision of the US President. And, of course, you know, it's not to say that it hadn't been sort of planned for some time, but then given that that's the case, you sort of think that maybe things might have gone a bit better. With that in mind, people maybe didn't anticipate that the Taliban would retake control of the country quite as quickly as they have done, and so you, of course, have had chaos. Chaotic scenes, very, very troubling scenes and distressing scenes being reported in the course of the past week.
Yeah, exactly. What about some of the speeches then in the House of Commons? And it was at its best, really, wasn't it, in terms of holding the government to account? And, we had Tom Tugendhat with a brilliant speech there, which I did watch live. And I noticed that it was actually widely watched in the US as well. They were watching that the House of Commons, because I think some people in the US are a bit worried now that they've kind of alienated a lot of their key close allies.
Yes, I think there's a consensus forming that basically we have screwed things up here, and it has to be a sort of a shared responsibility, because you can't just point the finger at any one individual actor. We have to look at how we've all performed in terms of the time that we spent in Afghanistan and what we're actually going to get out of it, which doesn't seem to be a lot. And then again, of course, you don't want to focus on just what we get out of it. You've got to look at the fates of so many people in the country itself and what's now going to happen to them, particularly women and girls. Now, I gather that we have decided it's going to be 20,000, I think, refugees that we will look to be accepting, and we'll be prioritising women and girls. We'll also be prioritising people who have helped us on the ground in the past, interpreters and other such people, which seems like a fair thing to do. But we'll also have to wait to see what the response from the rest of Europe is going to be for that.